This week, we're going to talk about metadata presets in Lightroom.
Adorama TV presents Exploring Photography with Mark Wallace, where you will learn innovative techniques on shooting a wide range of photography.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV, brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers, including Lightroom 5, and that's what we're going to be talking about for the next couple of episodes. Specifically, for those of you who just bought Lightroom 5 and you're setting it up for the very first time, there are two things that I highly recommend that you do. One is to set up metadata presets. We're going to talk about that in this episode. Next episode, we're going to be talking about watermarks and how we can set those up to use on export so our customers know who we are and people don't rip off our images. But this week, we're going to be talking about metadata presets. What is metadata? Well, metadata is all the information that describes your photos, who shot it, where it was shot, what lens was used, what camera was used, the shutter speed, all of that kind of stuff. Now, a lot of that is called EXIF metadata, and it is created by the camera itself. So when you take a picture, the camera is going to record all this information in the file. That's about the lens and the focal length and if the flash fired and the white balance, all that stuff. But there's all this extra stuff that we can add, like captions and headlines, ratings. We can say who created it, if it's copyrighted or not, all of that stuff. And all of that stuff is what we want to do in Lightroom. And instead of having to do that every single time, what we can do is we can create something that's called a metadata preset. And that way, when we import our files, all of that information that we want is going to automatically be added to our images. And it saves us so much time because we can just do it once and then use it over and over for years. So let's take a look at metadata presets in Lightroom 5. Hi, everybody. It's Mark Wallace. Make sure you check out Adorama's latest contest. You could win some great prizes. All right, let's take a closer look at setting up metadata presets. Now, to do this, it's very simple. At the very top of Lightroom here in your menu bar here, you've got metadata. Click on that and then scroll down to click Edit Metadata Presets. We want to create some presets here. So I'll click on that. And the next thing that happens is we get this metadata preset window. Now, what we want to do is we want to create a preset that is specific to all of the images, a global preset. So anything you ever shoot ever, you want to apply this preset. You could create presets based on location or maybe a model that you work with a lot or usage rights, things like that. It's up to you, but I'm going to show you how to do a very basic preset. And so what I'll do here is I'm going to leave alone. I'm not going to fill out any information that might change over time, like the copy name or the rating or the label, the captions, which camera was used, all that kind of stuff. What I'm going to do here, and I've highlighted these in red so we can see these pretty easily, is I'm going to focus on the IPTC copyright information because that is not going to change except for maybe when we update from year to year. So I'm going to type this in here. So this is 2014, and I will say copyright 2014 Mark Wallace. And the copyright status on these images is copyrighted. And that will be applied to all my images so people know, hey, Mark Wallace created these in 2014. They're copyrighted. Now, if you have rights usage terms, you might want to put those in here, unlimited usage rights or limited usage rights or whatever that is. And if you have a copyright info URL on your website, something that you could point people to say, hey, here's what I mean by that, you could type that in there. I don't, so I'm going to leave that blank. Now, the other thing that I want to fill in here is the IPTC creator information. And so, of course, that's me. So Mark Wallace. There we go. So those are things that you would want to apply to all of the photos that you would take all the time. So I shot these. Anything I shoot in 2014, I want this information attached to those images so that there is data there that tells me exactly who created that and why. So if you have multiple photographers in your studio, you might want to create a different preset per photographer. You can also create things like the date created in the intellectual genre, all that kind of stuff. You might want to do that. If you have something that is consistent, like the person shown in the image, maybe you shoot with a certain model all the time, you could throw that stuff in there. And there's all kinds of things that you can put into these presets, but we're going to leave this with the basic copyright information. So the next thing I want to do is I want to save this, all this information, as a new preset. And I'm going to save this as 2014 Mark Wallace. And make sure you're descriptive because you can have a bunch of different presets here. So, I'm going to say copyright. So I know that's what this is. So I'll say create. Now let's show you how to use this preset and make it meaningful. So I'll say done. Now, when I import photos. So I'm just going to go over here and I'm going to import some photos really quickly. So I'm going to go in here and I've got this Adorama TV shoot I did with Sharon a while back. You'll notice on the import dialog here on the right-hand side, there's this metadata drop-down box. So I can click that and choose my new preset. So if you have many different presets, you choose the one that is appropriate for the shoot. Then you would maybe put in some keywords here. I'll say Sharon and lighting, and we'll leave it like that. But you can really do a bunch of different things there. And now when you import these to your catalog, I'll just import these. What we'll see here in the library module, on the right-hand side, we have this metadata tab. You might have to drop this down. So you might have to click this disclosure triangle to drop this down. There's all kinds of different types of metadata. And so the one that we updated was called IPTC metadata. So I'll click on that. And now you can see that all the information that I entered, the creator and the job title and all that kind of stuff, is there. And so I've just entered it once, and now every single photo that's in this this imported folder is going to have that information. And so it just saves a lot of time. And then you can always go in here and you can add things like the headline. So I can say, you know, this is Sharon, and the description is Sharon looks to camera right, etc. And so you can say catalog, models. We can do all kinds of different things there. And so you can always add to this. And if it's something that you use over and over, you can always create a preset to be used by that. So metadata presets are going to save you a ton of time. And if you're brand new to Lightroom, that's one of the very, very first things I suggest that you do. Get in there and create a new preset. So every single time you import your photos, you can make sure that your copyright is attached to those photos. All right, well, next week we're going to talk about the other thing that I really recommend that you do when you're setting up Lightroom for the first time, and that is to add a watermark. So tune in next week, and remember, there's tons of stuff about Lightroom on the Adorama Learning Center. Gavin Hoey does tons of stuff. I've done some stuff in the past. There's Photoshop tutorials and everything. So don't forget to check out the Learning Center, and don't forget to subscribe because it is absolutely free. So do that. You're not going to miss a single episode. So hit the subscribe button right now. And thanks for watching. And here's my puppy right here. Hi, Cody. You wanna come up? Come on up. See, this is what happens when... Is it dinner time? It is? Oh, my puppies. Give me a kiss. All right, thank you. Now I gotta go back to work.
Do you want great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.